Can I now address my question to Madam Chairman Grace Pulidutan?
Senator Trillanes, before she testifies, may I ask the committee secretary to administer the oath to our COA chairperson?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Earlier, nakita po natin dun sa presentation ni Mayor Binay na meron na raw clearance ang Commission on Audit dito sa buong proyekto na ito. Meron po ba kayong binigay na clearance dito sa proyekto na ito, Madam Chair?
Wala po. Wala po kaming clearance na ibinigay at hindi po talaga kami nagbibigay ng clearance to the effect that, you know, there's no such thing. I mean, the commission does not issue clearances of the nature or the tenor that was described. If I may,
Your Honor, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I think I saw the presentation. What was flashed on the screen was the face or the front page of a memorandum that was submitted by the resident auditor at that time, Cecil Cagaanan. This Cagaanan is here beside me. It is a memorandum addressed to Director Carmelita Antasuda of the National Capital, who is our director of the NCR local government sector. So it is an internal communication, Your Honor. And I don't know how the city of Makati got a copy of it, because it's supposed to be, it was a report of Ms. Cagaanan to her immediate superior, Director Antasuda, and Director Antasuda in turn forwarded it to me. This is the memo dated February 17. So I think that was the most of what I heard on the commission, on the COA, I think was taken from this memorandum, which is really just a memorandum, an internal one, and is still being evaluated in central office by us. So I would say that this is at this stage, this is just a report, and it is being subjected to evaluation along with all the other pertinent documents and papers, Your Honor. In fact, this memo says, for your information and appropriate action. So, I mean, there's still a lot to be done in respect of this memo. Kasi po, as a matter of procedure, when we received the letter from Attorney Bondial, went through the process, the first thing that you really do is to ask the resident auditor, what is your comment on this? Or so they give this kind of memo to us, and then we evaluate. And we are in that stage, Your Honor. We are still evaluating.
Okay, maraming salamat po for that clarification. So, maliwanag po, wala po kayong sinasabi na walang anomalya itong transaksyon na ito?
I think that the what Ms. Cagaanan reported was based on prior audit reports, technical inspection reports na wala daw pang mga adverse findings. I think that was what she reported on. So, ito naman po ngayon ang aming binavalidate kung talaga nga bang walang adverse findings.
Yes, ma'am. The question is, ito pong COA, the COA as an institution, wala po kayong binibigay na clearance na nagsasabing walang anomalya itong transaksyon na ito. Ganun po ba?
As far as the records go, I did not
wala
see
po.
Any yet.
Wala po. So, Mayor Junjun Binay, hindi po totoo yung sinasabi ninyo na nilinis na ito ng COA. So if you will insist on using that, niloloko nyo po yung publiko. Kasi maliwanag po dito sa chairman ng COA na wala pa po silang binibigay na ganun. So, at least guided po yung publiko na hindi nyo na po pwedeng gamitin yang linya na yan na nalinis na ito ng COA, Mayor Junjun. That's just for your information. Anyway, yes.
Sir Chairman, with the permission of Senator Trillanes, just one point, Madam Chair, good afternoon. And this is more of an appeal. Your office has been in the forefront, no, of cleaning up government, of anti-graft. Has been controversial at times. We've been at the receiving end at times, but we appreciate, no, what you're doing. But not everyone can focus on hearings like this. No, I mean, even us here, lawyers, how many of us are engineers? How many are quantity surveyors? How many are in the construction business? So, yung detalye na to are lost upon the people. While people are complaining about lines or accidents in the MRT, kawalan ng trabaho, drought, everything, ang tingin nila sa hearing, politikong nag-aaway. Ang Binay, laban sa mga kalaban, as Mayor Binay also mentioned, LP, NP, etc. No? But I think what's confusing for people is how hard is it in a civilized country for us to know whether a building is overpriced or not, especially because there are international and local standards, no? So my appeal, ma'am, is I know you have a lot of processes. One of them is a participatory audit. I know you can include quantity surveyors, credible, nothing to do with parties, so that you won't also be accused. So my appeal is that I know you cannot do this for every single city or every single... And I know the feeling of Mayor Binay saying, bakit kami? Bakit kami lang? Dahil ba sa ama ko? But if you look at the perspective, no, the buildings that were shown a while ago and the documents I have, it amounts to about 8 billion pesos. Eh. This is close to the 10 billion, which is the whole amount for the pork barrel scam. And of course, Makati's looked at as a premier city. So, you know, masama man ang feeling natin that we investigate some people or we understand the feeling of the mayor. Whether it's COA or the Senate, pag nakakita ng alleged graft, we have to do this. But again, no, anuman magiging findings namin dito, maaring suspect sino ba pumirma, sinong hindi. Ang hindi ba, mga kakampi, kalaban. But if the COA does it very professionally with again, professional organizations, I think the public will know 100%. No? And so far, ma'am, you've been doing it that way. So let me throw this appeal to you, independent of this investigation. Of course, my full faith in the chairman, he handled the Dasmagate investigation, and I don't think Mayor Binay, Mayor Junjun complained. No? Senator Pimentel was very professional there and is very professional here. Thank you, ma'am, and that, let me throw that appeal to you, please.
Thank you, Your Honor, and rest assured of our independence and impartiality and fairness.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Let me address now my questions to Auditor Kagaanan. Do you confirm the amount of 2.7 billion pesos allocation for the car park building in Makati?
Your Honor, please, before I answer your question.
Ma'am, you can answer it. It's a pretty straightforward question.
Sir, no, because can I say something about my participation in this project? Sir, please, can I say something, please?
Okay, so go ahead, ma'am.
Yeah, the project was composed of five phases. Phase 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I assumed office in Makati on December 8, 2011. So I was involved in the last leg of the construction, which is 6.32% of the total contract. So when I received the letter of Attorney Bundal asking if kung na-audit ko na ba daw yun, and on the basis of the directive from the Commission on Audit, gumawa ko ako ng report. It is an evaluation report. When I say evaluation report based on COA memorandum, ilalagay lang namin yung brief statement of the project, ilalagay namin yung actions of the previous auditors, ilalagay namin yung recommendations ng previous auditors kung na-implement yun o hindi, at saka yung aming recommendation. So in this project, there were two audit, three audit groups. I was the third. And there were also three technical audit service group. I would want to clarify, because my name was dragged into it, and it is so painful to be charged with plunder. I would like to state that cases 1 and 2 were handled by my predecessor, the audit group, and cases 3 and 4, sumunod na naman. So ako talaga, phase 5 lang ho ang akin, with the third group of the technical audit specialists.
Okay, ma'am, I will actually help you. Antay niyo lang.
Yes, sir.
Ang tanong ko is, nagbigay view confirm na ang allocation dito is 2.7 billion pesos. Yun lang naman po.
Okay, sir. Oh, Your Honor.
Yes.
If you are referring to my evaluation report, that's table number 1.
Uh-huh.
Ang nakalagay po doon
allocation.
Allocation number 1, that's in page 2.
Mm-hmm.
If you have a copy of my evaluation reports, Your Honor. Ang nakalagay doon yung city ordinance.
Yes.
So ibig sabihin ito yung inallocate ng city council.
That was the
Pero, Your Honor, hindi ito lahat nagamit. Ang nagamit lang po ay 2.280 billion.
280 billion. Okay, ganito po 'yan the question was, do you confirm kung yung 2.7 billion allocated? Yun lang po ang sinasabi, tinatanong ko. Okay, di ba ho? Yes.
Yes, Your Honor.
So, yung sinasabi nyo, binayaran 2.276 as of, right? Kailan po yan? Nakalagay dyan sa inyo.
As of December 31, 2013, okay. Your Honor, ang nabayaran is 2.3 billion. Including the building management system.
Yes.
Kasama na po yun doon.
So yun po ang presyo. But as of December 31 ito,
yes,
kung
sir.
Meron pong subsequent payments, would it be included in your report?
Yes, Your Honor. Titingnan na lang siguro kasi wala na ho ako sa matatira.
Wala na kayo. So yun ang sinasabi ko. Ganito, naiintindihan po natin. Nasama po kayo sa plunder case. Actually, pwede po natin kausapin dito sila, Attorney Bundal, natanggalin na kayo eh. Di ba? So, we can help you. You know how these things go? Kung naman ho yan eh. Na-rectify ho naman yan sa Office of the Ombudsman. Pag nakitang wala talaga kayong kinalaman at nadamay lang kayo. So, kung lang po, naiintindihan natin how what you're feeling right now. But itong evaluation report ninyo, ito po ba ay categorical sinasabi ninyo na walang anomalya itong transaksyon na ito? Yan po. Straightforward question. Yan po.
Sir, pwede ko po dagdagan yung sagot kasi there is a delineation.
Oh, sige po, please. Please, ma'am.
At the commission.
Ma'am, sige, go ahead. You can qualify your answer. Apo.
Your Honor, at the Commission on Audit, there is a delineation of duties and responsibilities. The resident auditor is charged with the auditorial and legal review, while the technical review of the, especially for this kind of contract as infrastructure too, is lodged with the technical service office. And these engineers, we call them the technical audit specialists. No? They are not under my technical and administrative supervision. Naka-house sila sa central office, and then dinideploy lang sila doon sa amin. So, what we did kaming mga auditors, every time may darating ng mga kontrata sa amin, binibigay namin sa kanila, we gave it to the technical audit specialist para sila ngayon ang mag-review ng reasonable.
Yes, ma'am. Naintindihan po natin. Oh. Naintindihan po natin. Nandito po yan sa report ninyo. Pero ang tanong ko po sa inyo, ano po ba ang sinasabi nyo rito? Simple lang ho, nililinis nyo po ba si City of Makati dito sa evaluation ninyo na walang anumalyang nangyari dito?
based on existing reports, like the contract review reports, the inspection reports, files of the annual audit report, files of the notice of suspension, the audit observation memorandum, and files of the notice of disallowance, wala ho kami.
Wala, kami. Wala. Pero it, does that mean na walang anomalya rito? Yun ho ang tanong ko eh.
When we audit, Your Honor, we base it on rules, laws, rules, and regulations, and on the existing documents, considering
yun
that
ho ang
I
reason.
Was not the auditor for the four phases. I can only answer for the phase five,
yes, ma'am.
Your Honor.
Ito nga ho, no? In relation to the earlier concern of Senator Soto, kung ano ang legislation, dito ho natin makikita kung paano malulusutan at nalulusutan. Hindi ho ba? Kasi kayo, superficial yung inyong examination. Ang dami ho dito eh, na makikita na mga red flags. But, binibase lang, yung last COA auditor, sinabi nila, wala, di okay ka na. Yun ang presumption. Eh kaya nga ho, di ba nagkaroon ng pork barrel scam dahil nagkaroon ng special audit for that matter. Dahil nakalusot siya dun sa regular audit. Pinalusot siya ng mga auditors na nauna. Hindi ba? Kaya nung ni-review nung nagkaroon ng special audit, when they dug deeper, nakita ho yung anomalya. So, di ba ho yung yun ang sinasabi natin dito. Anyway, pero kino-confirm nyo at 2.7 ang allocation for the building. Yes, pero hindi na kayo aware. Ang naka-report lang doon sa inyo 2.3 billion plus ang reported payments, pero hindi na kayo aware doon sa subsequent payments dahil wala na kayo. Ganun po ba 'yon?
Yes, Your Honor, but based on the contract review reports of our technical audit specialist, the total cost of the project, no, from phase 1 to 5 is 2,280,089,780.94. It is not 2.7 billion. It's 2.2, excluding the furniture.
Senator Trillanes, excuse me, I'll just add.
Yes,
so 2.28 billion for construction.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yun, claro. Yes. Wala yung laman.
Wala.
For construction.
Yung fixtures, hindi na namin po nasama doon. Pati na yung mga elevators and everything.
Wala.
Doon,
okay.
Nakasama po
doon. Kasama na doon.
So, kung... yes, Mr. Chairman. So, kung ganon ho ang findings nyo. So, in short, ang tinubo na lang dito is imbis na 2 billion ay 1.5 billion. Ganon ho ba? Hindi ho. Just using the... sinisimplify lang ho natin, ano? Yung ano mga presyo. Anyway, Ms. Kagaanan, thank you very much. I will now move to
Mr. Chair, with again the permission of Senator Trillanes. Just one or two clarificatory questions. Ma'am Auditor, I understand what you mean, no? I understand you're saying na bakit ka sinama sa plunder, wala ka namang kilalaman, but also understand it from the people's point of view. Pag may sumulat katulad ni Attorney Bundal sa auditor, inexpect niya maging proactive ang COA. And in many instances under the new chair, COA was proactive, no? Or is proactive. So for example, ma'am, no? Are you familiar with this? Yung construction cost handbook ng Philippines. This is from Davis, Langdon, and Seiya.
No, Your Honor.
Okay. Anyone in construction knows that this handbook is used very widely. So even if you were not in the technical, hindi ba nag-alarm bell sa'yo na dito sa handbook, kapag ka-parking building, 12 to 18,000 lang dapat ang total cost, and then kapag ka siya'y average standard office, 26,900 to 33,000, and if it's a prestige office, ha, high rise na to, ma'am, ha, mas mahal pa to, 30 to 37,000, pero in just by simple mathematics, 70,000 halos per square yung sa building ninyo. So kung look at the public, no, eto publiko, sumusulat sa inyo. Ma'am, 70,000 per square yan. Walang private building sa Makati. Ang ganyan ang cost. Paki-audit nyo. Then you come out with a report that is basically quoting everyone but saying that it's all above board. How do you expect people to react now?
Your Honor, can I answer?
Yes, but my question specifically is dalawa, no? Number one, hindi ba man lang na-flag sa inyo na 70,000 per square versus 18,000 per square or 37 or more, 84,000 per square. Number two, how do you expect people to react to your report? And the mayor has been in all TV stations, have been in all the papers, winawagaygay ang inyong report. May I ask the third question, ma'am? Did you give the mayor a copy of the report?
I did not give the mayor
okay.
a copy of the report.
So, ma'am, can you answer them? Number one, hindi ba na-flag yung point na yun?
Your Honor, kanina sinabi ko na may delineation of duties and responsibilities ang Commission on Audit.
Yes, ma'am, but hindi ba kayo ang overall na pumirma sa report?
I only the evaluation report.
Yes, and the evaluation report, ma'am, said that everything was above board. You attach your name to a report saying everything is above board. You did not put there, yan ang sinabi ng technical, but ako, I did my own research, and in my own research, it's one-third the price pag tinignan mo. You didn't do that.
Your Honor, if you will read the complete evaluation report,
yes,
you will find that I consulted our technical audit specialists, the engineers. That's the reason na nagpadala sila sa akin ng memorandum. I asked them, ano bang basis natin?
That's correct, ma'am. Paulit-ulit lang tayo. May, you said that
nangyari?
And you said that you it's from the technical.
Yes.
So, klaro na sa amin na technical ang magsabi noon. Ang sinabi ko po, inattach nyo name nyo, hook, line, and sinker sa sinabi nung technical. Hindi nyo prinotektahan yung sarili nyo by simply getting this handbook. No? Auditor namin dito sa Senate, no? Even if they have a technical evaluator for consultants, she will look at the other contracts and she will call private companies and she will look, magkano ba takbuhan ng consultants now? She will not only rely on the technical. So I'm not saying it's your fault. Maybe you followed the manual. Maybe that's your job. But I'm telling you that how do you think Attorney Buldal will react and why did he include you? Because precisely ang appearance ng inyong certification is as if ina-absuelto nyo at sinasabi nyo nga everything is above board. Then suddenly we see that the normal is between 18,000 to 33,000 but lumalabas 70 to 84,000. So I mean, let me rephrase, ma'am, no? Hindsight, if tomorrow I write you a letter, magkano yung OSMAC? Will you look at this handbook?
The first thing that I will do is to refer that matter to the Commission on Audit because I am technically incompetent to
okay.
comment
now,
on the contract.
Thank you for that, ma'am. That's what we wanted to know, no? That you signed it but you're technically incompetent. But assuming someone who is technically competent write and say, ma'am, covered to. Okay to, ma'am. But they spent 70,000. Wala pa rin flag sa'yo na all the other private buildings in the same, say, similar type of soil and everything is one-third the cost? Hindi ka mag-note doon that you disagree with the technical evaluators? Or hindi ka maglalagay ng, it's really the technical, not you? Kasi, ma'am, ikaw ang pumirma ng buo eh.
Yung practice lang kasi namin, Your Honor, na kung may question ng technicality,
you pass it to them.
Pass it to
okay.
them. And in this particular case, based on the reports of the engineers, it's not 30,000 square meters. Kasi itong ang building na to, effectively 13 floors. May basement pa siya, second floor, third floor, fourth floor, fifth floor, sixth floor, the mezzanine, and then yung 7th floor, my 8th floor, the 9th floor, the 10th floor, the 11th floor, saka yung roof deck. And then ang total floor area based on the report of the engineers is 33,651.46 square meters.
What's your point, ma'am, by saying it's 34, not 32,000 square meters?
Kanina kasi ang narinig ko
sa... So you're just clarifying the facts?
I'm just clarifying
okay.
the facts.
It doesn't change, ma'am, the fact that 34,000... i-divide mo sa 2.2 billion will come out to about 68,000 per square and that is unheard of in the industry. So I don't know why pag mali yung technical, hindi mo sila kinu-quote, tapos pag tingin mo ngayon na 34, iku-quote mo sila. The point I'm making, ma'am, I'm not saying right now it's your fault. I'm saying my failure dito because people think that you can run to the auditor and the auditor will exhaust everything to find out. But you're saying now that the process is technical yon, but you attach your signature to the technical evaluator. But I'll leave it there right now, ma'am, so that we can ask to the others.
Senator Trillanes is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. What's the agency estimate for this whole project? Yes.
Please use the mic.
These are the approved budget costs, for, as Your Honor. For phase one is...
That's the approved budget cost, ma'am. But there is supposed to be an agency estimate.
This is the agency estimate,
so
Your
Honor. So how much is the cost there?
I did not get the total, but it, for phase one, it's
387,846,020. So who evaluated? So again, you're referring to the technical, what's the term? Technical...
audit specialist.
Technical audit specialist. I think, Attorney Bondal, ang dapat kasama doon sa plunder case nyo, yung mga technical audit specialist. Ano? Kasi apparently, sila yung nagbigay ng, pakisama nyo na lang. Ano?
Nakasama na po doon sa supplemental na, complaint po namin.
Sige po. So, anyway, that's all I have for Auditor Cagayanon. Let me now, Cagayanan, sorry ma'am. Let me now go to Mayor Junjun Binay, Mayor. You mentioned that this is a green building.
What I mentioned, Your Honor, is our version of a green building.
Your version. How do you make a building a version of a green building, Mayor?
By applying what I mentioned earlier, Mr. Honorable Senator, with the features of the atrium, our roof, garden, etc., Your Honor.
So that will, by adding those things, it will balloon the price of the building, so Mayor?
That was not in my statement, Honorable Senator.
Hindi. Dahil ginagamit nyo, parang justification ito na kaya ito napakamahal kasi green building siya. Ganun mo ba?
Ang binanggit ko po ay ito po ang features po nung building po namin.
So, it has nothing to do with the cost or it's not a justification. So, why cite it to begin with, Mr. Mayor?
Binanggit po namin ito dahil... doon po sa mga ginamit po namin na mga materyales. At binanggit ko din po ang isang malaking factor ho kung bakit lumaki ang halaga ay dahil nga din po doon sa lugar na pinagtayuan ng building, Your Honor.
Okay. You mentioned earlier that sila Attorney Bondal ay may mga inumit doon sa resolution. Ano po ba yan? Sino-sino po ba yan sila?
Honorable Senator, I can only remember two at this point. Si Vice Mayor Nestor Mercado and Councilor, he was then Councilor Kid Peña.
Okay. Mr. Chairman, can we invite Vice Mayor Nestor Mercado for the next hearing and also incumbent Vice Mayor Kid Peña?
The Secretary is directed to issue an invitation.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Babalik tayo dun sa phases. You mentioned, sabi nyo, because of the soft soil, you spent more dun sa foundation.
Yan po yung sinight ko, base rin ho dun sa report ng COA.
So, mga magkano po yung ginastos natin sa foundation?
Honorable Senator, I don't have the documents, but I can present it to you if you want the actual cost of what was spent, Your Honor.
So ano po yung terms of reference? Kasi you subdivided it into five phases. Yung phase one, ano yung terms of reference niya? Ano yung pinabid out nyo?
What I can cite right now, Honorable Senator, is the report of the COA citing that each phase was divided into several... 1 minute lang po. ito pong sinasabing work items involved at yung pong description. Nasa page 3 po, Honorable Senator. Okay.
So, dun sa phase 1, ano ang nakasama ho dyan? Yan na ba yung foundation? So, pag nagbibid, nagpapabidding kayo, magbidding tayo ng foundation lang. Ganun ho ba ang style sa Makati, Mayor Binay?
Honorable Senator, it is not within my competence kasi hindi naman po ako kasama dun sa Bids and Awards Committee. Pwede ko pong alamin kung ano po ang naging proseso at kung ano po ang nilalaman nung ito po ay binidding sa bawat phase, Honorable Senator.
Yes, Mayor, but we've been hearing you through the media and you seem to be sure that ang dahilan kung bakit nagmahal ito ay dahil sa pundasyon. So ngayon nandito na ho tayo, this is the proper venue. Ano ho ba ang nalalaman nyo tungkol doon sa pundasyon na yon? Magkano ho ba inabot yon?
Wala ko pong maibibigay ngayon doon sa actual cost. Ang binanggit ko po ay mga quote doon po sa lumabas na review na ginawa nga po ng COA.
Okay. So, in short, yun hong mga sinasabi nyo sa media ay ano rin, mga kuro-kuro lang. Hindi ito based on facts and evidence, Mayor Binay.
Honorable Senator, hindi po totoo dahil meron pong pinagbatayan at ito nga po ay ang report nga po ng COA.
Yung, wala ho dun, yung report ng COA sinasabi na malambot yung kayo ho ano auditor ka kagaanan kayong gumawa nito eh kayong sinasayto ni Mayor Binay na kaya mura kaya malambot yung ano kaya mahal dahil malambot ganun ho ba yon?
Your Honor, I consulted the technical audit specialist and then they yun. Submitted to me a memorandum that is annex Y of my evaluation report.
So ano ho, how much of the building went into that foundation? Kayo po.
Uh-huh. Your Honor, if I may refer you to the technical audit specialist, they are all here.
But andito ho yan sa report ninyo eh. Makikita nyo yan eh. Makikita nyo ho dito. It cannot be electrical works, right? It cannot be sanitary works. So, mabilis po natin pwede makompute yan. Okay? Tutulungan ko na lang po kayo. Base po dito yes. Sa inyong report, ang halaga lang ng structural works, ito lang po ang pwede natin gamitin. Para sabihin, para din sa pundasyon na yan, ang total ho dito is 600 million. 600 million ang ginastos ng Makati pundasyon pa lang. Yan ho nakalagay dyan. Dito ho sa report ninyo. Pag in-add nyo yan lahat ng structural works dyan, this is the figure that you will come up with. So in short, 2 billion pa rin ang ginamit pagpatayo ng building. So, yun nga ho ang sinasabi ni Senator Cayetani kanina. Ang dami hong red flags dito. Kaso, ang sinasabi niya lang, panay ang paghuhugas ng kamay, no? Na hindi sila naman gumawa, cleaner nila. Kasi ako, i-clear ko rin. Hindi kayo nag-kalkal ng mas malalim pa. Kasi bibigyan ko kayo ng isang red flag. Ha? Ito hong, for example, itong phase 4 bidding. Date of bidding is 28 July 2011. Tapos inaward yung contract 18 August 2011, 20 days lang. Ano? 20 days lang po. Okay, sa phase 2, for example, o phase 1. December 28 yung public bidding. December 28, ha? Tapos contract in award is January 18. tapos may mga holiday pa rito. So ganito hoy, ito yung mga the types of, and it involves hundreds of millions. Okay? So, almost all the phases, ganyan po. Tapos yung mga available amount, kunyari 500 million, ang winning bid is 499,357,000. Ito po yung winning bid. So, nakikita nyo yung ano, tapos, again, ang awarding of contract is less than a month. Alam nyo, naging procurement officer ako eh. And yung sa amin ho, basic supplies lang ang binibili namin. Ito ho, these are highly technical projects. So, yung mga yung post-qualification for that matter, ano ho ang ano, ang proseso dyan. So, ma'am.
Your Honor, can I pwede ba kita ibalik doon sa memorandum ng COA dated August 1, 2011 on the preparation of the evaluation report? May memo ho kasi kami kung paano gagawin yung evaluation report. Ang nakalagay doon, gagawa lang kami ng brief statement of the transaction complained of, previous audit action on the said transactions. Kaya kinukulate ko lang, parang ako ang data gatherer lang ng mga previous actions ng mga dating auditors at saka yung mga dating engineers na na-assign doon. And then, status of implementation of the audit recommendation, kung nag-recommend sila ng ganon, kung anong status. And then, other information deemed necessary in order for the fraud audit. So, pag-submit na namin ng aming evaluation report, diretso na po yun sa fraud audit, hindi na ho kasi ang trabaho ng resident auditor. And then, yung fraud audit, Your Honor, siya na ngayon ang mag-evaluate. So, lahat ng mga previous actions done by the previous auditors and the previous technical audit specialist, yung fraud audit sector, fraud audit and investigation office na Your Honor, ang gagawa ngayon ng recommendation, hindi ho ang resident auditor.
Yes, ma'am. Naintindihan namin kayo. Pero, this case was brought to your attention kasi nga may mga allegations na of overprice. Ang sinasabi natin dito, pumasok na sa consciousness nyo yung overprice and yet cursory pa rin yung ginawa ninyong auditing. Hindi nyo man lang kinonsult yung other sources that may validate yung binibigay sa inyo ng technical audit specialist. Kaya nga sinabi ho ni Chairman Grace Pulido Tan that because of this, i-evaluate pa nila yung sasabihin ninyo. And alam nyo, pagka lumabas sa special audit, itong mga datos na ito, talagang lalabas na kasama kayo rito. Yun lang po. Mr. Chairman, I'm finished. Thank you very much.